Minimum payment. Here is what they don't tell you about.
Yeah, today we are talking about minimum payments. Yes, we want to tell you all the truth about it. We don't want you to feel like you are paying some things that you are actually not. So here is the truth about minimum payments.
So, you know, in these beautiful days when you take your pickup truck, and you drive to the lake and you go fishing, you throw your hook and you hook that fish and you're like, yes, this is great, awesome, I got a fish, I'm gonna be reeling it all the way to me. It's exactly the same what this credit card company do to you, to us, and to everybody around.
We are the fish.
Yeah, they come to you with these awesome offers, throw you the credit card and you're like, free money, this is awesome, they're giving you $5,000 balance and you just, all right, life is good, let's go some spending.
Yeah, and how they hook you, showing you the minimum payment. Every time you buy something, you will see the minimum payment. Why? Because it looks so affordable, so convenient, and like you can pay it no problem, right? But this is the thing. In the minimum payment, what you are actually paying is the interest, mostly the interest from previous months, the balance you had the previous month. So they are charging you the interest from that, plus let's say 1% to 3% of your balance. So you are not paying that much of your balance.
Yeah, so almost all the amount that in the minimum payment is going toward interest.
Yes.
So you're going to be always covering the interest, they're making sure of that. And then there's tiny, tiny portion that is going to be going to the actual balance.
Couple of dollars going to the balance. And because you are keeping that balance every month you will be paying this interest. So yep. The interest from previous month balance, that's what mostly the minimum payment is. So let's talk about numbers so you can see it more clearly.
Actually see what's going on behind the scene. So we took an amount, let's say $2,500. So you saw this beautiful, amazing couch at the store that you went and you say, okay, I gotta have it. It's only $2,500. What is the minimum payment gonna be? Nothing. So you buy with your credit card, $2,500 couch. Your minimum payment gonna be about $41. It's $41.65 from what we calculated. $41.65, so affordable.
Nothing. It's you like can have a couch, beautiful, no-brainer. That match your dining table, match everything, all your decoration will look perfect. Perfect for the next party whenever you can invite your friends at home.
Yeah, which is no one knows when.
So it will look beautiful for only $41 and cents.
Yeah. So we said spend $2,500, minimum payment $41 with change. How long would it take you to pay it off if you don't put any more amounts on that credit card?
Let's say the only interest couch rate on this
credit card, 17.99. We just took the average, there's some 13, there's some 20.99, whatever. We took 17.99. It will take you almost 11 years, 10 years and 8 months to pay it off. And how much interest you would pay on it? $3,042.
Oh.
So it's like you're buying two couches and some extra cushion.
And by the time you pay it, the dog already peed there, your baby already
Oh, your kids already grown up and the couch already all messed up and the only place it's going is to the garbage.
And you're still paying it. The thing is that now we're considering only if you keep only that amount of money and you don't buy anything else. You just keep that amount and you pay it for only the minimum payments. But we know it's not the reality. What happens is that we continue using our credit cards. We continue buying. We continue getting in debt. So this is forever. It will be forever, forever.
You're always
interest.
There. Oh, and usually if you have $10,000 credit limit, you most of the people pretty much up there. Because they're like, okay, I want this now, I'm buying this now. Great, you bought this now, you got more. And then they don't want to bother you with the full amount, of course. So it's always the big number, it's your minimum payment. We don't want you to be stressed out and see how many years it's going to take you. They still have to disclose it somewhere in the tiny, tiny letters. They would show, okay, this is how many years it's going to take you. So you should check it out. So what the most important thing for you to do, always make sure you pay the full balance before you do that.
Yeah.
So then if you pay your full balance before the due date, you're never going to be charged interest. Plus, you just pay it off and that's it.
Yeah.
Instead of like accumulate more and more and just, oh, I only pay $50 this month. Oh, I'm only paying $60 this month.
Yeah, that's the thing. You get your statement, just go after this video, look at your statement. There is a balance amount. That is very big usually. And then there is like a very nice affordable minimum payment. That minimum payment is mostly interest. So you are not paying your balance. You are paying like pennies. You are paying a couple of dollars for that balance. So what you had to be committed to is to pay the full balance before the due date. If you pass one day, they will charge you interest. So before the due date, you can do it like 10 days before, you can start putting money every week, however you want. But before that due date, you need to have everything paid. So then you avoid the interest.
And very important thing to kind of switch in your mind. Because what do? We see something on sale. We're like, okay, this is no brainer. This TV costs $1,000. Now it's discount, $300. We're gonna get this amazing TV for $700. When you see that, what do you say? No brainer. This is awesome. I'm gonna buy this on my credit card and I'll put payments. The payment's gonna be so minimal, I'm not gonna even feel it. What end up happening that you pay for 2.5 TVs at the end. So pretty much all your discount that you just received and you were so excited about, you just gave it all to the credit card company.
And you have seen that most of these companies that have super good sales, they have the sales connected to their own credit cards. So all these department stores, they said, if you pay with our credit card, you will get
20% discount. Save 10%
because discount. They know they have done all the research, they have done all the analysis, they know that you will not be able to do the to pay everything before the due date. So they said that we will get that money, like hidden money, in the interest, and you will continue paying this minimum payment forever. And they will be just taking their money back. It's not a sales. It just take this sell kind of promotions and all these discounts out of your brain, because they always find a way to get their money back. That's the thing.
Yeah, so make sure you're getting out of this mindset that whatever on sale, if you have the money for it, fine, buy it if you really need it. But if you don't have money for it and you use your credit card, it's not on discount. You're going to end up paying not only your discount portion, you're going to be paying way more if you're just going to be doing the minimum payments.
And you have to be honest, if you have the money, it's very good to use your credit card. That's what we always do. We use our credit card, we take advantage of all the things, beautiful things that are outside there, all the sales and all these beautiful discounts. But before we even buy something, we make sure that we will have that money at the end of the due date, that we will have the money to pay for it. So that's what we mean with have the cash for. Not that you go and pay with the bills and say, oh, here you have $2,500 here and the coins.
Here you have
it. Yeah, we are not talking about cash that way. What we are saying is like, use your plastic, but make sure that you have the amount to cover that debt at the end, before the due date.
Yeah.
So that's how we work. We use everything that modern life give us, all this plastic, all these practical things that you don't have to carry money around anymore. And you use your credit card, but every time you make sure that you have the money to pay. If you don't have the money to pay for it at the end of the month,
don't buy it.
Don't buy it. That's what we do.
Yeah. And important things to remember, if we're already talking about credit cards, don't ever utilize more than 30% of your available credit. So let's say if you have two credit cards and between both of them you have 10,000 limits, don't use more than 3,000 on both of them together. So 3,000 maximum, as soon as you reach 3,000, you need to start paying one of the two credit cards, because if you start using more than 30%, it's gonna start hurting your credit history.
Yeah.
The best way, if you wanna be building your credit history, you need to have it use maximum 10%. So if you have $10,000 limit, you use only $1,000 and make sure pay it off before the due date so you don't incur any interest.
Yep, yes. That's how smart modern families are working with their credit cards. It will help your credit score, it will help your finances, and you have to take control of your life and don't buy this idea of buying things on sale or paying everything in very small payments, because at the end of the day, that money, you are throwing it to the garbage when you can be using it in something that is much more beneficial for your family, like growing investments and do something that really matters to you. Because who wanna buy a couch that will cost you twice or what is supposed to cost you? So just think about that. And the homework for now.
You didn't come here just to relax, no. I hope, because we got some homework for you.
Of course.
Yeah. So be ready for this. So your homework that will benefit you, just take your last statement. Go and check your minimum balance and just see how many years it will take you to pay whatever you owe if you're just going to continue making this the minimum payment on your credit card.
And if,
just check the small letters there. They're somewhere there. Take your glasses. Try to find it somewhere, because it's have to be there.
And if you need help, if you get all complicated and overwhelmed, just look at your balance, and you can write in the comments in this video and say, this is my balance, this is the interest rate, and this is the minimum payment. These three things you need to know. We can do all the calculation if you need to get clear, if you feel like it's too much. Don't, no worries.
Send it our way, we're gonna give you the calculation and shock you.
Yeah, you can write as an internal message, however you want to do. We want you to understand how this works. So if you get confused, just let us know and we will help you.
Yeah, I think that would be all for today. Thank you for joining us and sticking with us. We hope this video will help you to have a little bit better understanding of what credit cards are all about and how you should be paying it if you don't want to be overpaying thousands of dollars in your interest. So just do these small things and you'll be good. You'll be benefiting from the points your card give you. You'll be benefiting from, you don't have to carry a bunch of cash with you. And yeah, just by these small things, it's a great tool to use if you know how to use it.
Use it smart.
Yes. Make it count.